The trailer's pretty phenomenal for the upcoming season. Can you guys hint anything that you guys are actually doing, your characters, without giving too much away?
Saving the world.
Okay.
Again?
Rebuilding Again. Yeah. Society.
Yeah.
What does that look like at home, and what does it look like internationally? So,
I think what we do on this show is we really fight for the truth, and we fight to honor the truth. And I think a lot of the show is what happens is we don't know who's telling the truth, who to trust, and a lot of our navigating is getting to the source of the corruption. How do we extinguish the virus that has infiltrated humanity, and not necessarily an actual virus, but infiltrated the minds and the hearts of people, and that's what's at the bottom of corruption. And a lot of this season is, again, it's just saying the same, you know, age-old story of what happens when you put power in front of man. Does he use it for good or use it for evil? And you'll see.
So was it a more difficult physical season this time, or would you say pretty equal with ones and two?
I have, without giving things away, I have done some things that you've never seen me do on the show before.
Ooh.
Sort of. Yes, sort of.
Striptease?
So there's that. So yes, a little bit more physical work for me. And yeah, just
not
in
that
terms
kind of physical
of,
work.
Just in terms of,
there is no striptease.
There is. Let's just be very clear. Okay.
And before I was sitting, you know, primarily as the TAO in front of a computer screen, and now I'm a living, breathing human being in the White House. So.
Well, she gets to let her hair down this season, and she gets to really show her leadership in a totally new way. Mm-hmm. And watch out for this one this season.
What about you? What does this season hold for you?
The season holds for me, I think there's a new sense of purpose that I carry forward in my missions, and having to deal with, you know, certain times being away from the exact place that I want to be, but putting that on the side and carrying it with me while I put mission first. So it's something that Danny Green has experienced a lot in this season. It's just a bit more rich between her and I, and it's nice to carry that forward.
Well, and this season there's going to be a lot of separation between all the cast members, right? So was that kind of hard on the set because you're not working with the same people you normally get to see out all the time?
Yes, but it also in a way it makes the playing those scenes of heartbreak where, you know, you're not with your loved one, a little bit more real. Because we haven't seen each other on set for a while.
Yeah, well, what's great about it too is it also creates a more dynamic storytelling, because we have all these different areas where we're telling really, really rich stories, and then connecting all of those in such a beautiful way. I feel like it's going to give our audience a lot to grip, a lot to chew on. So, to me, I think it, you know, regardless if we see each other a lot or a little, I think story-wise, hands down, best season yet.
So. When you look back at what you've done on the show, is there an episode or a scene that you're really proud of? Something that you see as like the defining moment for your character?
You know what? I think that there was a moment that I really enjoyed watching from season one where I had to tell her, I just found out she was pregnant, and I had to tell her, I basically found out she was going to die, and I had to go say my final words to her. And there was just a moment that you and I had where I saw the state that you were in, and I said, don't you dare leave me. Because I knew that there was more. My hand was on your belly. And just that connection that you and I had, that was I really, really enjoyed that scene.
And I, at that point, didn't know I was pregnant. You were the only one that knew. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, Adam told
us... say her scene.
Yeah, I can't really say my scene is coming, I think, this season.
Give us a hint.
Where the hints... There's a moment where I have to make if you were in the panel or if you were in the other room, where Kara is at home and she's the senior military advisor to the president. She has to make the right military decision that is so hard to make for her heart. And so that I think sums up who Kara is. You know, that she's going to do the right thing. She's going to do the military decision she knows she has to make. But that effect, that could affect me for the rest of my life.
Okay.
Adam told us that this is the most popular show in the Navy or naval culture. So I just want to ask, how vital is that Navy approved to you for this show? How important is that?
Well, I mean,
the fact that it's approved by them.
It's everything, because we're wanting to be as authentic as we can, and that's why we have so much Navy personnel. That's why we have the advisors, we have the Navy SEALs on set at all times, we have their proper uniforms and the equipment, and we use the actual ships. So to have their approval, it's what makes the show. So I think without that, I don't know what kind of show we have. So I'm honored to, if we have their approval, to have it.
Mm-hmm. You want to get it right.
Yeah.